6:43 in the morning. So the night before last, I ended up going to the ER because I was put on a medication to see if it would help with my pain. But instead of helping with my pain, it actually made me like violently nauseous, where I pretty much didn't eat or drink anything for 2 days. And if you have dysautonomia, it's not good. Dehydration for people with dysautonomia is pretty much a no-go. So I preemptively went to the ER around 9 o'clock last night, and then I was given Reglan, which is an anti-nausea medication, which also gave me really bad side effects. I was having a lot of weird, like, muscle spasms, and I felt like I was crawling out of my skin, and I was sitting up, and I was lying down, and practically just writhing on my bed, because I felt like if I quit moving, it would make me feel worse, and I was just, I felt anxious, and it was all bad. Never, ever, ever taking that again. But I did get my IVs and whatnot, and went home and fell asleep around 2. Well, fast forward, they'd also given me Benadryl with the Reglan, knowing that I was going to get that side effect. But I don't think not as bad as I ended up getting it. But they knew I was going to have that side effect, so they gave me Benadryl. So the Benadryl helped me sleep last night, which was great. So I slept until 4 in the afternoon. Unfortunately, I slept until 4 o'clock in the afternoon. So I first had trouble sleeping because I'd slept in too long, and then my body just hurt. My hips hurt, my knees hurt, my back hurt. So I didn't sleep last night. But today I'm going to be driving down again. I have my Stanford appointment to do my lidocaine infusion tomorrow morning, and I have mixed feelings about it. I am both excited at the prospect of it working and slightly terrified of the prospect of it not working, because at this point I've had a couple different weird reactions to different procedures and different meds, so at this point I'm a little gun shy, I think. But since it is almost 7 in the morning, I figure I'll quit trying to fight the good fight as far as sleeping goes, and actually maybe jump in the shower and get ready to go.
I'm not gonna lie, I was feeling pretty out of sorts this morning. I had a lot of congestion and a lot of back drainage, so I pretty much decided I had a cold. So I decided to put on one of those menthol patches to give myself at least half a chance to be able to breathe. And what's not to love except concealer? Because we're not gonna let anyone know that we got absolutely no sleep last night. And I believe somewhere in here, I decide I'm going to drop my pencil. Nice going. I usually start my mornings off listening to people like The Fry Life and Chronically Jackie because I just love how they approach life, and they're always so funny that it's a great way to start my mornings and kind of kick my day off on the right way. Lastly, I had to get the tape residue off my arm from my ER trip the night before. Yes, it happens. Yes, it happens often. And yes, I do have a box of alcohol wipes in my room for that reason.
So it is a brisk, oh gosh, I want to say it's probably in the 30s, maybe low 40s right now. My feet are freezing, but it's a really nice day, so I thought I'd bring you guys out here. So, let's give you an update. So, I've been to Stanford a couple different times. So, this will be my third visit, but my past visit, I went and talked to the CSF leak guy and was there for quite a while. I would say I was there about an hour and a half, hour and 45 minutes, and went over a bajillion different questions. And so at the end of my visit, he had a couple conclusions, a couple hypotheses, and a couple tests he wants to run. So part of the reason why we're leaving early-ish today is that I have to get some blood work done because he's wanting to test some certain levels that can indicate whether or not I may have a CSF leak. He said there's a 65 to 75% chance that I have a CSF leak. And so the way to test for that is to do what's called a myelocephalogram with a CT scan. It's basically fancy talk for I have to get a spinal tap with contrast, and then they'll send me through a CT scan and it will show where I'm leaking, basically. He said it's not a definitive test, but it's certainly more accurate than what I've done so far. I'm not looking forward to it, not at all. But at this point, it's been about a year and a half going as far as the symptoms I've been having, so I'm ready for some forward progress. So I am sort of looking forward to getting poked in the spine. It's complicated. But yeah, so I'll be getting the blood work done. I'll be getting the spinal tap done, and if that comes back and says I do have a CSF leak, next what they'll do is do what's called a blood patch, where they do something very similar to a spinal tap, but instead of injecting contrast, they'll actually inject my own blood into my spine, and it kind of works as a band-aid and helps promote healing and heal up the patch. Only 33% of patients have improved symptoms and have their leaks go away the first time. So I'm pretty much banking on at least two blood patches if I have a leak. So if I do have a leak, I roughly have three spinal taps in my future. But it's forward progress. And if it is what it is, it's something fixable and it's something that isn't surgery. So I am happy about all of those things. And I'm happy that I'm finally getting progress and I'm finally having people listen to me and finally starting to kind of get the appointments rolling instead of having them all be 3 months out, 2 months out, 4 months out, which is what I've gotten so far. So I am optimistic, more than a little scared, but also more hopeful than I've been in a while. So I am crossing my fingers. We will be leaving hopefully in the next few hours to start heading down to Stanford in the Bay Area and to check into our hotel, and I'll bring you guys with us. We are finally on the road. My mom is accompanying me today.
Good morning.
We're about to get on the highway, and then how long is the drive again?
About 4.5 hours.
Gross. Checked into our hotel, and I'm just gonna be editing the video for a little bit before we go to bed and go to my appointment. I will see you in the next video. Da, 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 da. Get to the chopper! I mean, probably not.